problem is to write a Python program to reverse a number. Hello everyone, a very warm welcome to WsCube Tech. My name is Ayushi Jain, and in this video we will learn how to write a program that would reverse a number for us. Guys, what is a reversing of number over here is that suppose if you have a number, let's say 1, 2 and 3. Okay, and if you want to reverse this number, then the reverse of this number would be 3, 2 and 1. In Python, we can do it by a very simple method. We have two solutions by which we will be doing this. Our first solution would be using the while loop, and our second solution would be using the slicing method. So we'll be seeing both of them one by one. First of all, let's talk about using the while loop. For using the while loop, first of all, I'll tell you the logic that we are going to use, then we will write the program. So here, as we need to find the reverse of a number using WLS while loop. Okay, so what we will be doing over here is very simple. First of all, we need a number as an input from the user. We will be taking a number. Let's say the number is 1, 2 and 3. You can take a user input or you can create a predefined variable. Also, we will be needing another variable called as REV. In the reverse, we will be inserting 0 value. Why 0? Because later inside this reverse, we will be obtaining the reverse of this number, that would be 3, 2 and 1. Now, how to obtain 3, 2 and 1? For that, first of all, we will be giving a condition that while this number is not equal to 0, in that condition, what should happen? So, what we need to do, we need to obtain the reverse. So, reverse would be what? 3, 2 and 1. For that, first of all, from here, we need to obtain 3. How to obtain 3 over here is very simple. We will use the modulus function. How to use the modulus function is, we will be using this number that we will be creating a digit. We will be getting a digit. This digit, how to get this digit, we will be writing 123. That means this number, when divided by 10, whatever remainder it gives, it would be this digit. So what remainder it would give when divided by 10? So if I divide it by 10, I'll get 10, 23, so 2 and 20, and the remainder would be 3 over here. That means inside this digit, I will be getting the remainder 3. So digit would be equal to what? Our number modus 10, which would give us the last digit over here. After this, what we need to do, we need to add this digit inside our reverse. So right now reverse is 0. To this reverse, we need to add this digit. How to add this digit is very simple. We will be writing reverse is equals to whatever our reverse is. Suppose it's 0, right? Right now it is 0. So reverse multiplied by 10 plus this digit. Okay, because what we are doing, we are getting the single digits over here. Later, what we will be needing, suppose first digit is 3. Next time it will be 2, right? So we will be needing not 3 plus 2, that is 5. We will be needing 32 over here. For that, what we will be doing, reverse would be that time the reverse would be 3. So 30 plus 2 would be there, 32. In this way, it would work. Okay, so right now, let's just talk about the first iteration. In our first iteration, we have received the digit. We have received the reverse. Lastly, what we need to do from this number, because now that we have received this number, we need to eliminate this number as well. So to eliminate this number, what we will be doing, you can clearly see in this division method over here that on the top we are obtaining 12. That means if I remove 3 from here, obviously we will be obtaining 12, right? So how we are obtaining it? We are getting this as a quotient. To obtain the quotient in our Python, we write number is equals to number floor division 10. By writing number floor division 10, we will be obtaining the quotient, that would be 12. So now the number would be 12 this time. Again, the same iteration will happen. And now what would happen? To obtain the last digit, we will divide this by 10 and we will get the remainder 2. And this time the reverse would be what? Reverse would be 3. Again, reverse multiplied by 10 would be 30 plus the digit would be 2. That means it will become 32. And from this number, so from 12, we will eliminate it by using the floor division, and we will remove this 2 by floor division, and only number that would remain over here, that would be 1. Again, the iteration would happen because we have given the value, because inside the while loop, we have given the condition that while number is not equal to 0. So again, this iteration will happen, and what would happen in this case, 1 would be the remainder over here. Again, to the reverse, reverse will be multiplied by 10. So reverse is 32 right now, so it will become 320 plus 1, which would be 321, right? So this is what we want to obtain in our reverse, and this time from the number 1 will be eliminated and the loop will stop, because now this number will be equal to 0, and in the condition we have given that while the number is not equal to 0, till then we have to execute it. As soon as it will be equal to 0, we will stop executing it, and now it will become 321. That means inside the reverse, we will be obtaining value 3, 2, 1, which is the reverse of 1, 2 and 3. So this is how we will be obtaining it by using the while loop. Let's have a look on how we can write this code inside our Python. So using while loop, for that what we will be doing, we will be creating a variable called as reverse is equals to 0. For that, first of all, we need to create a number as well. For number, if you want, you can take the user input. So I'll be taking the user input and integers input, enter a number here. Once we have written a number here, we will be using our while loop, that while number is not equal to 0, while number is not equal to 0, in that condition, what do we need to do? We need to first obtain the last digit. For last digit, I'll be creating a variable called as digit. Digit is equals to number modus 10. And after that, in the reverse, we will be adding this digit by multiplying it by 10. So reverse multiplied by 10 plus the digit. Once we are done with this, to eliminate the last digit from our number, we will be writing number is equals to number floor division 10. And this is how we will be obtaining the reverse of the number. So lastly, we will print the reverse of the given number is, I'll put a comma over here, and we will be writing REV. Now let's run and see what output we will get over here. So suppose I have written 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the output would be 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. That means we are obtaining the reverse over here by a very simple method. Again, if I run it and write over here, let's say 7, 8, 6. Then the output would be 6, 8 and 7. That means our program is working perfectly fine over here. This is our method number 1. I hope this method is clear to you. Let's move ahead to our method number 2, that is with the help of slicing. So let's have a look on how it can be done. For slicing, first of all, we need to again take the user input as a number. That number is equals to integer input, enter a number here. Once we have taken the input from the user, what we will be doing with this number, we will be applying the method of slicing. After we have taken the input from the user, we will be writing print, and we will write here the reverse of the number is, and I'll put a comma, and I will convert this number into a string, because we cannot apply the string method, that means the slicing method, over here directly on a number, because it is an integer. So we need to first convert it into a string. So I'll be writing str and convert this number into a string. Then we will be slicing it. For slicing, we will be writing colon minus 1. Now what is this colon? Colon minus 1 is indicating over here. This colon means the default is the starting value, because we don't know that how long is the number. So we don't know what is the starting value. Also, we don't know what is the ending value. So it might start at number 0, but we don't know what is the ending value. The length of the number could be 3, 4, 5, 6. It could be anything, because we are taking the input from the user. So I am giving the starting value as default, that is colon, ending value as default, that is again colon, and this step in between, the step between each number should be of minus 1, that means we are going all the way reverse. So for reverse, we are writing minus 1. So all we have done over here is taken the input from the user as a number in integers. After that, we need to write the reverse of the number is, first of all, because we have taken the input as an integer, we need to first convert it into a string. After we have converted it into a string, we can apply the method of slicing, where we can obtain the number by writing colon minus 1. That means colon are indicating the default value, and minus 1 is indicating that we are going reverse inside it. Also, let's run this first of all. And if I write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it would give me 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Also, there could be one more thing that could be done. That is, if you remove the string from here and you remove the integer from here, that means you don't only take the input in integer. If you directly take it in string and write here, enter a number here, you can directly take the input in string also. Or if you want, you can take it in integer and write string over here. So choice is totally up to you. In that case, you don't have to write number in this way. You can simply write it in this way. And if I run it, I'll get the output, let's say 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I'll get the output 6, 5, 4, 3. That means in both the ways program is working. In our first method, we have seen the while loop, and in our second method, we have seen the use of slicing. In slicing also, there are two types. One is you can take the input in the integer and then convert it into a string by printing it. Other method is you can take the input in string and then directly apply the string method, that is the slicing. So I hope guys that both the methods are clear to you. The link of this code is present in our description, and for more such interesting videos, stay connected guys. Thank you.